The jersey retirement is big because, you know, you didn't really see that at the beginning. You just wanted to be a part of something that was already great. You know, the green and gold already had a legacy, and I was just a small piece. But to be singled out and, you know, be up there in the rafters for years to come, that means a lot, you know. Like I said, to me, it means a lot knowing all the work I've put in, but it means more for my family.
How has it changed your life just ending up at Norfolk State?
I mean, you know, I came here as a young man and I left much mature. You know, I was the first time I ever left my mom and dad. You know, first time they trusted me by my own, I had to make decisions and they trusted me and I met great people along the way. But Norfolk State just gave me a tremendous opportunity. And with that being said, you know, I want to say I held up my part of the bargain and they did theirs.
Omaha.
Okay.
2012.
Yep.
ESPN still calls it the biggest upset in NCAA tournament history.
I'm glad to be a part of it.
I know. So how did that change everything in your life?
That just showed the world that we were ready. You know, we were ready that day. We've been ready that year. But we had a national stage to kind of, you know, showcase our talents. And, you know, that was big for us. That was big for the university, big for even just the city of Norfolk. That was a big one.
It's pretty big for you, too, wasn't it?
It was huge for me. You know, it gave me many opportunities, you know, but I don't think that I could have had that opportunity if it wasn't for the squad, the team, and the coaches believing in me the whole year.
You were kind of a late bloomer, weren't you?
Yeah, super late, 12th grade.
So how'd you turn that into success?
You know, just believing in myself. And honestly, it may sound, I may be going around in a circle, but the people I have around me, you know, my parents never bothered me as far as putting any pressure on me. They trusted any move that came about, and we prayed on it, and it's been working, you know. The last 10 years of my life as far as basketball has been great.
Let's talk about the more recent years of your life, the NBA. Is it the similar formula? You pray on it and figure out where to go?
I mean, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't want to change it now. You know, it helped me this far. You know, I wouldn't want to change. But the NBA is more of a job. You know, I go to work every day. I punch a clock in. You know, my family respects my craft. You know, they give me my space, but they also know that I need them too. That's why they're here, you know, and I try to be with them every chance I get. It's just much different because this is my job, this is my livelihood, and, you know, this has changed my life tremendously, and, you know, my family's as well.
What's your favorite part about NBA?
My favorite part about being in NBA is, man, going out there every night, you know, showcasing your talents, you know, streaming all over the web, all over TV, and you got 20,000 people in the stands. I mean, there's no better stage than being out there.
Do you have a message for maybe not even basketball players, for young people you deal with?
Oh, yeah, of course. I always go with the control what you could control. You know, that's all you can, you know, and I like to use AEE, which is attitude, energy, and effort. You know, that nobody, you don't have to work out for that. You don't have to do much for that. That's all on you. When you walk out the door, you control what you can control. And I think good things will just naturally happen when you kind of, you know, take those things in your own hands.